In this video, I'm going to show you how to compute zonal statistics by group. In the last video, I already showed you how to compute zonal statistics using a polygon and an image. But the image was just continuous data. Sometimes we might want to use categorical data, for example, length use, length cover. So one application example is that you might want to calculate the length use and length cover composition for a state or for a country, right? So for example, what's the area of forest within the state, and what's the area of a water, vegetation, like different land use, land cover. So if you're just using zonal statistics, you only get a sum or standard deviation or mean, but you don't get the area for each category. So this is what we are going to cover here in this video. First, let's go to the website to download the notebook example we're going to use in this video. The website is tutorials.gmap.org, and then analysis zonal states by group. When you click the link, upper right corner, download the notebook, and then you can download to any location. It's safe. Once you downloaded the notebook, then we can open Anaconda prompt. So go to start menu, Anaconda prompt. Then we can conda activate GE and Jupyter Notebook. Enter. Once Jupyter Notebook is open, then we can navigate to the directory GE. And so we'll be the last one here, zonal states by group. In this example, I'm going to go through two different examples. The first one is to analyze, for example, the US land cover. And the second one is to analyze global land cover. So and the first one here, we're going to use the 30 meter resolution. The second one, we're going to use the MODIS resolution. So the NLCD is 30 meter resolution. The global MODIS land cover is 500 meter resolution. Okay, so first let's import the libraries, and then we can create an interactive map. So next, we're going to add some data. You can click the link here to go to the Google Earth Engine website to take a look at the NLCD, so National Land Cover Database. And this one is one of the most comprehensive land use land cover database for the US. And recently, the image collection ID just changed. So now this is the new one, but what we are going to still use the old version, it still works. So the NLCD has every 5 years we have one time period. So right now the latest one we have is NLCD 2016, and the last one will be NLCD 2011. So on and so forth. So this is the image collection ID, and within this image it has multiple bands. So we just going to use the length cover band, and then we can add this one to the map. Also, we're going to add the US state boundary from the census dataset 2018. And so all we need to do is just execute. Then you should have these two dataset loaded on the map. You can zoom in. Keep in mind, this is just for the contiguous United States. It does not cover, for example, the Alaska and other islands. So we just want to focus here on the continental US in here, and you can turn the layer on or off. So for example, the US, and you can also just turn this one totally off, right? In this example, we're going to calculate, for example, in here we have 50 states. We want to calculate the land use land cover composition for each state. For example, here in Texas, what's the area of agriculture? What's the area for grassland? Or what's the area for urban area? So we're going to use a GMAP to do that very easily. So, but before we do that, we might want to add a legend. So GMAP has a built-in legend called NLCD. So you just need one line of code, map.add legend, and then just hit one. You should be able to see this one here on the map. Also, we can turn this one off. So now if you, for example, if you navigate the map, you can use the inspector tool to click on the map. You should be able to see, for example, the pixel value. So length cover 71, right? You can take a look at here, 71 represent grassland. You can also click somewhere here. This is 82, means 82 cultivated crops. And you can also maybe the red color, this will be urban area. So if you click red color 24, represent develop high density. So 21 to 24 represent urban area, mostly just human built up area. And 41, 42, 43 means forest. And so 51, 52 means scrub and grassland and so on and so forth. So the last one, 90 and 95, these two belong to wetlands. So once you are familiar with the land use, land cover type, then we can go ahead to calculate the zonal statistics by group. So what we are going to do, first we want to set the output directory. So we're going to set this one to under the user directory. The reason we're using this is because it's this should work on multiple platforms, for example Windows, Linux and Mac OS. So if the downloads folder does not exist, it's going to create a folder. And let me take a look at the downloads folder first. Downloads, right? So I have something in here. Let me just delete to make it empty. Then we can execute this line. So next, once we set the output directory, we also want to set the output file name. So because after we compute the statistics, we can export a CSV or we can also export a swap file. But to make it simple, we're just going to export a CSV name, NLCD states sum. And so the zonal statistics by group, this is a function provided by Gmap. You can hit Shift Tab on your keyboard to bring up the function definition. So the first one here is the input value raster, and the second one is the zone vector, and also the output, the statistical type by default, it's sum. So basically we're going to calculate the total area of each land cover within its polygon, right? And you can also set a denominator, because if you have a large area, you might want to divide it. For example, in this case, the denominator, let me execute first because it might take some time to calculate. The denominator basically here is 10 to the power of 6. So because by default, it's going to use the square meter. So if we use the denominator, that means the result will be divided by this number. So it will be converted to square kilometer in this case. And also you can set the decimal places, like we just want two decimals, right? So after execute the function, you will see here, this is the result, and the result have been downloaded to the output folder, and this is the name. Then we can open the CSV to take a look. By the way, so here we just calculated the sum, right? So later I'm going to show you how to calculate the percentage, but I'm going to execute first because it's going to take time to run. And now let me open this CSV and we can take a look. So here we have the multiple columns, right? So for each polygon, so each row represent one polygon, one state. And so some of those don't have data, like as I mentioned earlier, it does not cover, it only cover the contiguous United States. So Alaska and Hawaii and others are not within here. And so first let's take a look at the data and scroll to the right. Let's take a look at the name column. So the name column represents the name of each state, right? And on this column in here, from let me scroll to the left, right, class 81. So 81, 71. So the number represent the one on the map. So if I come back here again, just to show you, for example, 81 represent pasture and height, right? 82. So the number represent the land cover type, just to make sure that you understand the difference. So at 95, also you might notice that here the number is not all ordered alphabetically from the smallest to the largest, because when Google's engine export the data, sometimes it's random. So this one is out of your control, so you cannot really control how Google's engine going to structure your data. But most likely those the data columns in the later, those are basically the from the swap file, from the polygon swap file. And these are the new ones being added in here. And so from 81 all the way to the last one. But you also need to pay attention, there's another one here, class sum. Sum means the total area of like the raster within like a vector. So basically it's the area of each polygon, right? So 4,000 Keep that in mind because we change the unit to square kilometer. So it's this is like 4,000 square kilometer, and this will be the total, right? So add up this all together, the total will be this one. So why do we want to calculate this? As the example I gave earlier in this video, for example, if we're trying to figure out which state has the largest area in terms of, for example, largest forest area, or maybe let's say agriculture. So if you are trying to figure out which state has the largest agricultural area, then we can use this kind of zonal statistics by group to calculate. So the agriculture here is class 82, right? So we can go back to here to the CSV. So 82 will be this column, right? So we're going to do the sorting, but you might need to select the entire spreadsheet and then go to data. From here, we can click sort, and then so sort by class 82, right? And we want to find out the largest one. So from largest to smallest, then hit OK. Once we have sorted the data, then we can click the first one here. So this will be the largest one, right? The largest the row. So we can take a look at here on the right, what's the name of this one. So the first one here is Iowa, right? And then the second one is Kansas, North Dakota. Then we can go back to the map actually to do a quick check, right? So Iowa has the largest area in terms of agriculture. So if you want, we can also maximize to take a look at the map. Then we can turn on the US states and we can take a look. So here, if you are familiar with the US, so this one here will be Iowa, right? If you click on the map, you should be able to see the vector data being so here this one is Iowa. So and then also the next one, I think it says Kansas, so it might be somewhere here. Okay, and also North Dakota, South Dakota. Because you can see from the brown area, right? So those are basically area represent by represent agriculture, and you can clearly see that okay, these states have larger agricultural area compared to other states. And so you might want to ask the question, for example, which state has the largest, for example, forest area, and which state has the largest urban area, for example. And those are the things you can answer using zonal statistics by group. If you want to find out, for example, the forest, forest has multiple types. You can combine these all together, or you can just look at just one single type. Let's look at, for example, class 42, right? Evergreen forest. And we're trying to find out like which state has the largest one, forest area. It probably somewhere in here, because you can see the green color concentrated here on the west coast. And if you want to find out the definite answer, then we can look at the spreadsheet again, come back to here. So like I said, it's class 42, right? So it'll be this one. And again, this select all the data, and then sort. So it'll be class 42, largest to smallest, and hit OK. And then to be to select the first one here, this is like 86,000 square kilometer. So the first one here, the largest area, forest area, is state of Oregon, and the next one here is California. So if you come back to the map and we can take a look, right? So indeed here, so this one here is Oregon. You might need to maximize. So this one is Oregon, right? And the next one is California, and the third one here is Washington. And Montana also has a lot of evergreen forest. So this is things you can do easily after you get the results. Similarly, if you want to find out what the urban area would be, for example, from 21 to 24, you can certainly use the spreadsheet to combine these all four together. Or you can just look at, for example, just 24, which state has the highest urban area, like high density urban area. You'll be class 24. And again, let's do the same thing. Select all the data, and then data sort, and then class 24, largest to smallest, right? And then select which one. Okay, so the first one here, largest one is Texas, and then California, Illinois. This is no surprise because those are the big, many of the major cities are actually in there, and Michigan, Florida, New York. Okay, so those are just some simple examples. You can come, if you have other questions, you can use this spreadsheet to actually to answer and address the questions. So the first one here is calculate the sum. As I mentioned earlier, you can also calculate the percentage, right? So everything else is the same. The parameters, except here, the statistics types is sum. So sum is the total area. Percentage means the length used, length cover composition by percent. So we can open this one here, the result. And here we have. So now you see here, this is all the decimal numbers. And also we have the other one here. This is the same class sum. That means sum up all the area together. And this one is in square meter. So this is the original unit. So it is still in the square meter. And all the others are decimal numbers. If you want to calculate, if you want to verify, you can do that. So in here, because this is by percentage, so suppose that you have all the classes, when they add up all together, it should be 1, right? 100%. So if you want to try out, you can maybe do sum. And we can drag all the columns together. But make sure you minus this one, because this one here is the absolute number. We don't need this one. And then if you hit enter, you will get here 1. So it's suppose all the state you will add up is 1, because this is like a percentage. And similarly, you can find out, for example, which state has the largest in terms of percentage, which state has the largest percentage of agriculture or forest or urban area, right? Similar to what we did earlier, you can also use the result actually to answer your questions. Okay, so this is for the US. And next one I'm going to show you is analyzing the global land cover. So we're going to use the MODIS global land cover. You can click here to go to the Google Earth Engine website to take a look at the data information. You can look at more metadata information in here. For example, how many bands within each image. And so in the example, we're just going to use the first one here, the land cover type 1. And you can also see, look down here to see more information about the legend. For example, the color table. So each color and also the description of each one. And let's come back. So we're going to create the map. And so the first one here, we're going to add the data, then use land cover data, MODIS. And this is how we're going to visualize the data, right? Minimum, maximum, and also the color palette. So the palettes come from here, right? All the color actually come from here. And once we have the data, we also want to add the polygon. So this one is the country polygon, and this one from my user account, but it's public, so we can also use this one for all the countries. You can click on the map to inspect the value. For example, if you click here, you're going to show here the land cover, for example, 12, and also the USA, the ID, and also the name of the country. Similarly, you can add the legend. So we also have the other built-in legend for MODIS data. So if you want, you can run this one. It should add the legend to here. And so you can see all the values in here. When you click on the map, for example, if I click here, you're going to see the value here is 12, right? 12, you can come back to here. Crop lands, so basically agriculture, right? If you click on the green area, it's going to show you here land cover type 4. This will be deciduous forest. And for example, you can click red color area, gray area, so those land cover 13. It will be urban and built up area. Similar to what we did, you can continue to explore dataset for other countries. But in this example, I'm going to show you here how to quickly calculate the land use land cover composition for all the countries. So basically at the global scale, and you just need one line of code. You don't need to do like repetitively. And this is very, very easy to do. Similar to what we did earlier, zonal statistics by group, right? So the image and the polygon, and you set the output. I'm going to save this one to the output directory. And also we're going to calculate the sum, converted to a square kilometer, and we want 2 decimal places. And the last example is to actually calculate the percentage. So then use lane cover composition by percent. And if you this take Eager SQ, and we can take a look at the results in here. Global states some CSV, and so once it's open, then you can look at the last two few columns here represent the name. So in this case, we can maybe just trying to answer some question that we raised earlier. For example, at the global in all countries, which state or which country has the largest? They say, let me come back to you. Agriculture, for example. So if you want, we can take a look at here. Agriculture is class 12, right? So it'd be cropland. And cropland, so the urban is 13. So we can look, maybe we can just look at these two classes, see which country has the largest agricultural area and which country has the largest urban and built up area. So let's come back to here. Let's remember 12 and 13. So let's look at 12 first, class 12. Select all of them, data, sort, and then 12, largest to smallest. And hit enter. Okay, so look at the country, India. So India has the largest area of agriculture, and then US, China, Russia. So if you want, you can go back to the map to take a quick look, see if it's true or not. So this is US, and if you go to India, right? Well, this is indeed a locked of agricultural area. Oh, lane cover type. It doesn't show up in here. Weird. But the color actually is showing up in here. So might be just some weird issue. Anyway, so India has the largest area, agricultural area, and then the US and China. Similarly, we can maybe take a look at the urban area. So it would be 13, right? Class 13. Again, we can do the sorting and then try to find out here, class 13. Hit OK. And in terms of urban and built up area, so the largest one here is the United States in terms of urban area, and then China, Brazil, Japan, Russia, Germany. So these are some of the countries that has the largest amount of urban area. And if you scroll down, you can take a look at the smallest one, might be those small countries in here. Okay, Greenland, right? No surprise, nobody deep in Greenland. So you won't be able to actually find any urban area there. It's all zero somewhere here. Okay, I think that's all about this video. I hope you can use this to apply to your own data and then try to compute some zonal statistics by group and to answer some of the questions that you might have. And I hope to see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.